in today's Warhammer Fantasy Bat Rep. The Ogre Kingdoms once again take the field of battle to fight against the Orc and Goblin Horde. And in today's Vault Bat Rep, we are going to go ahead, re-rack, and have a rematch with my Ogre Kingdoms versus Steve's Orcs and Goblins. That's pretty much all just orcs, though.
We play and call it work.
Mini Wargaming's Warhammer Fantasy Battle Report.
Today, my 2,000-point Orc and Goblin army is going to be led by an orc shaman. I was going to call him a weird boy shaman, but that's 40K. This is a savage shaman. Savage shaman? No. Dang it. What are the savage ones called? This guy's Frenzy. Okay, that's all that matters. He's Frenzy, so that I can give El Gigante some war paint. That's it. Now, my shaman here has the Shrieking Blade, the Earthing Staff, and we're going to have four spells. I always roll before game, but last night, while preparing for this game, I was having a conversation with some buddies, and they're laughing at me for various reasons on this list. They think this only can work on a certain combo of spells, so I want to roll on camera for them to show that I will get the exact combo I need. Now, the list will have a unit of 38 Biggins with hand weapon and shields. We're going to have the Banner of Eternal Flame, 100% to Taylor, 100% aware. And they also have a 20-man boy squad right next to them with double hand weapons. We're going to bring two Orc Boy Chariots, two 10-man Orc War Boys, guys with spears and shields on boars. And
then
a couple of Mangler Squigs. Okay, we have a Battle Center Bear Black Orc Big Boss with just the Armor of Destiny, and that's it, actually. Now, let's go ahead and roll some spells. 100% worked. Okay, what do I need here? We're gonna need a foot, ear, and hand. Because they're all here. And then I go, yeah, it might work, guys. It's not gonna work. Now I feel bad. It's not gonna work.
What did you need?
These four. Well, these three.
Okay.
Actually, you know what? I don't want headbutt. I'll trade headbutt for the gaze. How many wounds do your wizards have?
I can't remember.
Do you have more than one wizard?
No.
Should I headbutt you?
I mean, I'd rather you not.
All right, then I won't.
Yeah, because I'm able to heal every time I cast.
I know, but eventually you'll die, right?
Yeah, probably.
Something has to die.
And here we have my 2,000 points worth of ogres. Trying something, I don't know, different-ish. Just to see if I can get it to work. So, leading the army, we have a Slaughtermaster, level 4. Went for kind of a different configuration because I'll try something different eventually. I gave him the Armor of Destiny and Grutt's Sickle. So he should be fairly dominant in the magic phase, unless I roll really bad. Because he can get to +7 to cast without trying too hard.
Joke's on you, we just throw bodies at your spells. We absorb your magic with our dead.
I think pretty much everything just boosts.
Oh, he healed his buff.
Yeah, I have pretty much just buff spells.
So your meat will be extra tender when we feast upon your ogre flesh?
More than likely.
Or extra buff?
Heroes, I got a bruiser here. Great weapon, heavy armor. He is a BSB. Went for the big name of Death Cheater, so I can basically, I think it's, I pick a model in base contact before wound rolls are made, and you get a reroll successful against him once per game. Could work. Might work.
I don't plan on fighting in close combat.
And then we got the Dragonhide Banner. What? Yeah, you're just going to send the squeaks at me? You're going to squeak
at me? Everything I have is about close combat. I got to fight you.
I'm looking at your list going like, I think he's going to fight me. I think he's lying. Over here, I have a Ogre Hunter.
Wait, what does the Dragonhide Banner do?
That's the one where I charge. I get two reroll hit rolls, wound rolls, and saving throws of one on the turn I charge.
Oh, okay.
And then it's got a once per game breath attack that gives always strikes last to the enemy.
Right. What's your initiative though? Because we're all initiative 2.
On him, I think he might be initiative 3.
No, but your army as a whole is initiative 2 for ogres, right?
Yeah, overall it's a 2
so
for ogres.
It will matter.
I mean, we'll see. Ogre Hunter went for the big name Longstrider to make him a little bit faster. And then I did give him the Shield of Tolos, so he's got a 1-up save against shooting. And then the Tormentor Sword, just to kind of get in the habit of taking a magic weapon on him. Because against, well, to be fair, Luca, I just want to be able to kill ethereal stuff with him. Yep. Won't matter against Steve, but again.
What does the Tormentor do?
I got no idea. It's pretty bad.
It's
one of the 5-point ones. It's one of the 2 5-point ones.
Okay.
That I think it gives stupidity to a monster he hits or something like that.
Okay. I did say I brought the shrieking blade of my wizard, right?
What does that do?
It gives me fear. My blade shrieks, so it's all scary.
Can you give everybody an idea of what that would sound like? That sword?
Yeah.
Just like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
And now my guys are brave and your guys are all scared.
No, it just causes fear, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, but when my wizard causes fear, my wrestler guys aren't afraid anymore. Because the blade's going re.
That makes sense.
This is obvious.
Core choice, I've got a big old unit of 17 ogres. Standard bearer, BSB, champion, and then give them all additional hand weapon. So I don't know, they're there to punch stuff. If they die, I lose. For rare choices, I've got 2 iron blasters. And then special, I've got a unit of 6 lead belchers with a bellower. And way over there, 2 separate choices of kitty cats. That's my 2,000 points of ogres I don't normally play. Rolling for the Slaughtermaster spells. Okay, I think that's the exact same roll you got.
It actually was the exact same roll I got.
Nice. After trying to make my mind up here, I think what we're going to do is Bullgorger, Toothcracker, Trollguts, and then instead of Brain Gobbler, because Brain Gobbler's kind of fun, but I think I want the Stubborn more than anything else, so we're going to go Spine Marrow. Scenario time. What are we doing, Steve? Bam!
2 with Dawn Attack.
I don't remember what any of them are. Is this the one we get to roll to see if guys show up?
Yep. Well, then. So in this one, we roll off the season to go first. Whoever rolls higher isn't a player or entire army first, but it's going to be kind of a random deployment. We'll show after fear who's going first. So I'll be going first. So basically, I'll be setting up my army first, and then I'll have first turn. However, Josh will have the ability to roll a die. And if he rolls a 6, I had to pick who goes first. But Josh can roll a die. If he rolls a 6, he has to pick who goes first. But what we do now is I join characters as units, and we roll a die for every unit as we deploy them. So for example, I'm going to put my 2 characters inside the horde of biggins, and then I'm gonna deploy them. I have to roll a die. Roll the 6, consult the chart. I can deploy them anywhere I want. If I roll a 1, I have to deploy them here. If I roll a 2 to 5 here, no, sorry, 1 here, 2 here, 3 to 5 here, 6 anywhere I want. So we'll do that, and we'll show you where they end up.
Armies are deployed.
This is how it happened. I get all this in the center. Kind of had to put cavalry, I can't even say it, in behind because none of room in my frontage. And then one flank, giant and chariot, other flank, squig and chariot. I rolled a squig probably too late. This is the only spot he could fit when I rolled center. So both my squigs, I wanted my squigs in my flanks typically, yep. But hey. Josh didn't get that much better. This is Abyssal Wood rolled as I deployed in it.
Now, the other one is, you want to talk about the swamps?
Okay, we're using these as mist.
Mist Reed
Swamps. That means if you're in it, you have, if your majority models are in it, you have hardcover. However, at the end of your movement phase, you must pass an initiative test or D6 models get dragged under by the Famir.
This is pretty awful.
Neither one of us want to beat it, but it's way worse for you.
See, the way we did it is Steve just read the names and I picked, not knowing what they were, just whatever sounded cool. So that's awful. Can we not fight now?
Well, no, that's the thing. So in any other game, we would typically now dance around it. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk right here. Be like, come on.
No.
And to be fair, Josh set this table up not high.
Yeah, I just kind of put stuff randomly on the table. Oof. Okay. We've got Iron Blaster. Big old unit of bulls with the BSB and the wizard. 1 kitty cat, lead belchers, iron blaster, and then the hunter with the other kitty cat.
Okay, Josh, you get to roll a die. If you roll a 6, you get to pick who goes first.
Ooh, you ready for a beard?
Yeah.
I'm
gonna go first. Oh, it's recording. Okay. Before charges, I gotta do some animosity.
Ooh, yes.
Front boars. All right. Ooh! Oh, goodness. Okay. So I roll a die. If I roll a 1, I fill in a monster, and then I consult the chart. This one's going to mean I'm going to search for it and have to charge. So I'm going to move and then charge.
Okay. Fight me, I guess.
Okay, so after checking the FAQ, I have to pivot to the closest enemy unit, which was them, but I can't pivot to them and get in my front arc at all. So it's in my front arc. So I have to here, and I have to, so I move forward, and I have to declare a charge. If I can't declare a charge, I can move and act normally. However, I'm pretty sure I can declare, because that is just over 17, I move 7. That is a 10 charge, well, which is dread. So that's them.
You're going to do the rest of your animosities first?
Yeah, that's them. Okay. So we'll do the next one.
Attaboy. Attaboy.
Okay.
What is 40?
Squabble. If it's possible to charge, I must do so. If I can't declare a charge, I'm going to declare a charge. Breaks out of you. They move. Wait, I can't. They're done. They're done. It's the turn.
Okay, so they just squabble, but there's no damage done to them?
Yeah. Big squad. They're fine. Little squad. They're squabbling. They're done. Orcs.
Do you gotta do the chariots?
No, anything with less than 5 models don't have to do it.
Okay.
You can't fight with just 2 guys in a chariot. I mean, you can, but... Dang. Okay, so charges declare. They have to clear a charge on them.
Okay, I guess I can't stand and shoot, so I'm gonna
you
just...
You can't?
They're solidifier.
Ew. Yeah. That's all my charges. I guess that's stupidity. I'll just do it real quick. Yeah, we're fine. Yeah,
Swift Stride, get a 10.
I made my charge. Okay, well, this turned from really bad to maybe really good.
Who knows?
And then turn, and then all the way, and then close the door. I can win that fight, right?
I think
they're not biggins. They're not biggins.
I don't know what that means.
They're just regular boys. This Mangler Squig is gonna move. I'm gonna go. You know what I'm gonna do for simplicity?
Now, do you declare the direction then roll, or do you roll and then declare?
Yeah. Okay. They have no frontage. I'm gonna use this foot to kind of like declare the direction.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, that's not that bad.
Let's say that. Okay.
I guess this guy. You're gonna go here. I think it's this Squig will go all this way. He's gonna go right for him, I guess. Nah.
He's coming right for us. So it's 21 point Squig that's gonna have a 65 point. That's gonna have a 21 point cat go touch it and then they just both die.
The cat, you need the squad?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not going that way then. I already rolled it, it's too late. Oh, that's terrible.
Actually, how does that work?
No, where was I? If you can leave the squad, there's no way I'm going that way.
Well, I'm trying to figure out, because now I'm thinking about this. Because it's a squad, so how does this work? Because the character can leave, but then the cat's got to stay still?
No. He could activate normally. Okay, yeah. Because, Josh, you can't charge these squigs. Knowing that the cat can just, like, this... Oh, so... You can't charge your squigs, but Josh can move into him. And as soon as he moves into him, the unit takes 3d6 strength 6 hits, and then my squig immediately dies. So obviously that doesn't make any sense. So he'll go directly towards the house, and I rolled, I can't remember, I rolled an 8.
Yeah, 8 towards the house.
Yeah. Just to keep him alive for a turn. How far can that cat go?
Cat's move, I believe, is 8. Or they 7.
They can probably get them. They can probably get these anyway. Oh,
yeah,
nothing I can do about that. Okay. These are gonna march.
It's over there in the middle.
So we're just gonna make sure. Whoa. We're gonna wheel up a bit. Kinda, if you make that charge, we want you to come into the forest. I mean, into the swamp.
Those guys are squabbling, right? It's a good try.
Hey now. We will march.
We gotta get you some animosity markers.
It's true.
Not because you forget, just because they're cool.
Man, I think that's it. Winds of Magic.
Okay, let's see what the Winds of Magic roll is gonna be.
A lot of channel.
Nope. Does Josh channel? He does not. Okay, 2-1. What do you want to cast?
How many wounds do the cats have?
Two.
Is it more than one?
Yes, it is more than one.
Well, we are gonna try to two dice the foot of Gork.
Okay.
We got it. You want to just re-rack?
No. Okay. So what's the foot of Gork do, Steve?
Well, I wasn't gonna go stomp the cat, so you can't just give a manger swing. I think I'm gonna stomp something else.
Okay, I'll let you take a look and we'll come back in a minute.
Here's what's hilarious. I mismeasured the cats. They're both, neither one of them can reach my magnet swigs, so I wouldn't have cast that spell, but I did. I'm gonna go ahead and stomp the big unit.
Okay, so stomp the big unit.
Okay, so basically, I don't have a template, actually. If anybody has a foot template, I would like to purchase it for you. If you wanna email me, steve@miniwarmean.com. However, it just functioned basically the size of a chariot base, so I'll do that. Oh, I gotta get my scatter die. I'm gonna put it right there. And it's gonna go back six. And lands right there and does nothing.
Warhammer Fantasy Battles, folks.
See the newscast. I'm gonna use my earthing rod. Okay, nah, that's not bad. I'm gonna take a strength six hit, wound me on a three, and a four board. Oh, take a wound.
Not bad. Down to...
Down to two.
Nice.
Ba-bam. Okay, and then because I didn't declare large, that's it. I'm not gonna keep rolling, keep going. We're shooting, I ain't got none. So, let's go into combat.
Yeah, right over to combat.
You got Sphere, correct?
Yes, I do, sir.
I'm scared.
Boo.
Do you have a champion?
I do not have a champion.
All right, we're both same initiative. No, my boars are faster. But they won't kill enough to... Oh, they could kill enough. So my boars will fight first. My boars hitting on fives. And we're strength five on the charge. So threes. Two wounds.
Okay, they're just going to go through.
Okay. Spears from the boys on fives. And then we're strength three, four, five. So threes. Nothing. And then the boss is higher strength. But he gets no hits. You know, fight me back.
Swinging back into the piggy wiggies, hitting you on threes, because you fear me. Then these are looking for fours to wound you. Not a great roll, only four wounding hits.
Three of save. I take one. Oh, because you're strength four.
Yeah.
Three of save, so minus one.
Okay.
Okay.
No stomps because of cavalry.
I've done two wounds. I have charged. I have a banner. You've done a wound. You have a rank. Do you have anything else?
I don't think so, no.
I went by two.
Ooh, now the BSB is not in range for the reroll here.
Oh, no. To be fair, the only way I could have hurt them this turn is if I rolled a one, then a six, and then a ten of charge.
That's fair.
So you weren't that bad being out of
Well, I BSB did deploy them first anyways because I kind of wanted to see, but they ended up over there. All right.
Ooh, I think you're running.
Oh, yeah, they're definitely running.
We're gonna chase.
Oh, no.
I think I caught you.
Yeah.
That's gonna panic the cat and the cannon.
Mm-hmm. It is. Okay, let's see what happens with the cat. He's leadership four, so he's...
Well, who's your general? He's definitely using his leadership.
No, cats can't.
No way.
100% they can't. The cat's going, I got a swift stride away from you, right?
Yeah.
7 inches back this way.
Okay.
Kitty cat's going to end up over there. Iron Blaster? Nope, he doesn't like it. He's gone. All right. We're leadership eight here.
Okay.
They're fine. Oh, these guys are gone. You got to go far, how far forward?
Oh, you have to roll your run. You may roll 12.
No, I already rolled.
Oh, you rolled? Okay. So I went 11, right? I'm going way over here.
That's a substantial part of my army that just left. I killed a pig, though.
You did. You
so
did.
There is that. Oh, BSB. I'm going to see. I don't think the reroll... I mean, I was obviously not in range. I don't think it would have helped. Yeah, it wouldn't have helped. I would have been gone anyways. Oof. Alrighty, let's go over to... That's the end of your turn?
That's the end of a very successful back half of a turn. What the heck just happened?
Ogre's turn one. Alright, start of the turn. Charge to declare. No, thank you. Not gonna do any of that. So let's just get over to...
I'm the luckiest man in Warhammer.
Yeah, I don't know how that all that chain of events all went down that way.
I'm the luckiest man in Warhammer. I know it too.
Okay. Kitty cat, rally? Nope.
Can you get us another Pedicus?
Let me just get rid of him. That's one less unit I have to move. Pretty handy. Playing right into my plan, Steve. Alright, we're probably going to go in the think tank for a couple minutes. And we'll be back with what happens. Alright, everything has done a little move. So the hunter and the cat split up. They decided that we're not going to do that anymore. So cat moved over, hunter moved up, just to try to get into a range to do something, maybe? Iron Blaster moved back a little bit to be able to put a shot into El Gigante and maybe hit the chariot. And then I marched up close to the swamp. That's that. I think we gotta go over to Wind's Magic. Let's see what we're gonna get. Okay, getting a 5. I get one channel attempt. Yes.
Okay.
I'm gonna use Grutt's Sickle to inflict a single wound onto the unit I'm with.
What does that do?
I get +2 to cast now for the rest of the turn. But at the end of the turn, I roll 2d6.
Uh-huh.
I think it's the end of magic. I gotta double check. As long as I don't roll double ones, I'm fine.
Okay.
If I roll double ones, I'm removed.
People don't even roll ones in miniature war games. It doesn't happen.
Not at all. All right, I've got many dice to work with here. We're gonna start off with a spine marrow. So I'm gonna try to keep all this bonus to my casts going. So spine marrow.
What does that do?
Gives them stubborn.
That's a 10?
I get a grand total of +6 to this, so yeah.
How many dice you got?
4. I can give myself +1 strength, +1 toughness, and regen.
I'm gonna give you the stubborn.
Okay. Lore attribute. And I pass it, so I get +1 to cast my next spell.
Yep.
I throw 2 dice at Toothcracker now. Do you get a dispel scroll in this or no?
No, I didn't bring one.
Okay. Neither did I.
I figured. You have it.
Okay, lore attribute. And +1 to cast the next spell. And I'm gonna throw 2 dice at, do I want the regen or do I want the +1 strength? I'm gonna go Bull Gorger for the +1 strength. So getting +7 to cast that. So showing grand total of what, 13?
You're gonna split your dice?
I'm gonna dice, yeah.
Oh. This is Dobbit.
And there we go. So I got 2 spells off. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. Shooting.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing that can go wrong here. I really want to hit the giant more than I want to hit that chariot. So let's go 10 from the back of the giant.
10 from the back of the giant. Do it up.
Okay.
Okay. 8 from the back.
And then I get to roll. Basically, I roll this twice and get to pick which one I use.
Gotcha.
It's 4. And a misfire.
I'm
gonna
take the 4.
Yeah.
So you're...
And that still is one big ol' miss for me. So I think that's my turn.
Interesting. Well,
let's one word forward, friendo.
Let's do some animosities. Okay, yeah. They're fine. These borders are fine. Big squad, fine. Little squad, fine. Stupidity. Wait, they're stupid, right?
He looks kind of stupid.
Wait, not stupid. I'll roll a double check. No, I can't remember. I'll double check that. Okay, so, charges. Okay, so, what's the initiative on this guy here?
I'll find out. And before anything else, I guess I should probably roll for my sickle. Okay, they didn't murder him.
Now, the only charge I have to declare will be this chariot into that cat.
Why do you charge my cat, bro?
I don't know. Keep him from dealing with me. I'm walking into mangrove squigs.
So how did...
So what's going to happen here is I'm going to wheel all the way till I get past him. I'll end up going that way and clipping him.
Yeah, that does make sense. So he just dies, and that's unfortunate. I guess I could flee? The which is kind of, yeah, he might get away if he flees, so I guess I'll just flee.
Okay, you,
I'm going to measure it first just to see if this all makes sense and kind of look at the angles, but yeah, I think that's what we're doing. Yeah, kitty cat, run away. I'm going that many. What's your charge distance?
Oh, you gotta go first, but I'm gonna fail. Yeah.
No, wait, do you match?
No, you're still you're one away from me.
One, yeah. So one further than
this. I'm gonna wheel all the way.
Ta-da! All right.
Okay. This guy here is gonna go see if he can pop through both those things.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Oh, no. No! I think I'm gonna be good.
You might be, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Mm. Okay, so on this angle, I'm going here. I have to pop through. I can't stop there. I pop right through.
Oof. And rolling damage.
So they're going to take 2d6 hits. 7. I don't have the dice here.
Should have got more dice, bro.
I know.
I'm embarrassed for you. Are they strain 6 or strain 5?
Strain 6.
Okay.
So I'm going to go on 2s.
Should be 3s because I got that plus 1 toughness up right now.
You did. 5.
That's just 5 damage. So, dead. Dead.
Then the cannon.
Kanonin.
Is going to take 6. What's your toughness?
Let me check. Yeah, he's toughness 6.
We're looking for 4s. 3.
Okay, so he's down to, I think, 2 wounds left.
And now I can't control that squig anymore. He's gone crazy. The squig. The squig is going to go after this guy.
The hunter?
Yeah. 11?
Oh!
I don't think so.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, I was going to say, I tried to stay more than the average away. Still kind of spooky.
Okay, remaining moves. Let's go over there and do a swift reform. That's a fail. So it's just a reform. We're going to go like this. We're going to kind of aim so we can get the rear there later. Not quite the charge I want, but it's the charge we got. Let's see what a march takes me here. The problem with this, I'll be fine. Let's march these guys. Actually, let's see if I can get, I don't think I can get your flank, but I'll try. There's 8. And then we'll go 10. Let's go 2 more.
Yeah, because their move, what, 8?
They're 7, so I got 14. Gotcha. And we'll go, there. Now let's see if I made it to your flank or not. It's a 50-50 right here. Let's see, move up. So after I charge, is that right? Let's just do this. Let's force Josh to take initiative tests and lose models.
D6 models, eh?
D6 models, yeah. Whoa, I'm moving the table. This giant wants to go like this. And this chariot, like this. And then these guys will march. And so basically, it's going to be this and then this.
Okie dokie.
Okay, well, let's do Winds of Magic. We have 5 and no channel.
My channel, no.
Oh, actually, real quick, my wizard's frenzy. I want to not charge, and I'm not charging.
Okay, yeah, because he's, yeah, at least leadership 8.
Let's do a foot of Gork with 3 dice. We got it. It's 12 plus 4. Not bad, 16.
And that's strength what?
Strength 6, D3 damage.
Oh.
But it did not throw the big one, so it's not going to repeat.
Okay. I think I just really want to get rid of this.
Okay.
The rest of it, I don't know, some shenanigans, but... Oh, let's throw the dice at it. I don't know if I actually stopped
11?
That.
No. No, you did.
Yeah, I just tied you.
You tied me. You did one more. Okay, well, let's go for the same spot.
Okay, right in the middle of the unit.
Yeah, we're going to try to hit, like, a direct hit. We'll get, like, we're trying to, like, you know what I mean? Oh. Okay. Interesting.
That gets many.
So it is 9 hits.
In strength 6?
Yeah, but you're toughness 5 still?
T5 right now.
So 3's to wound. You saved 1.
Okay, so no save. No save.
These are D3 damage. So the first. Wait, is there any reason I don't roll them all together? No.
Yeah, you can just roll them all together.
9. 12. Wow.
Uh-huh.
Well, come at me, bro.
Do you got anything else to do on your turn?
Nope. Right, no, here we go. I got it. Everybody within 2d6. So just them. And
that's the reroll hit rolls?
Yeah, they're rerolling the hit.
All right, so now nothing else in your turn?
That's my turn.
Okay, let's go over to Ogre's turn two.
Do you have any charges to play?
Start of the turn here. I guess when in doubt, charge. So I'm going to have the Hunter declare a charge against the Boar Boys.
Yep, they're going to...
A move 7.
Move 7, so you're going to be guaranteed. So how many attacks you got?
More than a couple.
I'm going to hold here because I should be fine. Yeah.
Now these guys are just going to go straight ahead charge.
We'll just take this out of the way because we know you're going to be in it.
Yeah. And then...
I'm holding, obviously.
Yeah. We'll send the chariot into El Gigante.
You're going to hold.
Maybe I can do a thing.
Giants aren't stupid. Why don't you think they're stupid? Trolls are stupid.
Trolls are stupid. Aren't giants stupid too?
No, they're stubborn.
Just because you're stubborn doesn't mean you're stupid. I'm living proof, friendo.
Oh my god. Okay.
All right, charge distance. Chariot, go, chariot. I got to roll pretty high. I don't think it's high enough. Let's check.
8? How about you, 6?
Yeah. Never mind, pro chariot charger. Get him. Moo! Over here. Charge distance.
I think you rolled a 1. Oh, goodness. Okay. You fail.
Because it's the pelt.
He is 3. No, he's using it. He's in. He's good.
Yeah.
I laugh so
hard. I'm 6.
I think I measured 6 and brought down your 2.
Yeah.
He just did. He couldn't feel that.
Yeah. I was hoping for an overcharge, but I guess I'm not going to get it.
I think this one, you move 7. I don't think you can possibly fail this.
I don't think I can either, but again, the overcharge.
Oh, that's right.
Doesn't.
I'm going to move this so you don't tip over.
Yes, thank you. He's not glued on to that base very well. He's metal.
He held on, okay.
I get to see if the kitty cat rallies.
No.
Nope.
No, he's not going to rally.
Nope. How far is he going to go? Yeah, he contacts them and then just keeps on going. Fantastic! Winds of magic!
Yeah, buddy. 6, I'm going to channel. Nope.
Do I channel? No. Well, I am going to go ahead and use Grut Sickle and do a wound to my unit. End of the movement, basically, I do the initiative test. Initiative 3 in the unit.
So you're going to use you will use initiative 3. So you fail. So D6 mauls flee. 4.
Now, I'm not going to lie, there's a reason I use that other list.
Well, hold on. This is a perfect storm of stupidity today, though.
It's true. Okay, go back a second. I got to do the dangerous terrain, so this is on the unit.
Nobody failed. You're good.
They're fine. BSB. And the sorcerer. Oh.
Hey, don't even bother marking, you're going to heal.
Yeah,
right?
When I cast. Unless I don't.
That's true.
So yeah, well, no. We'll see this first cast. I'm going to start by throwing 2 dice at good old Bullgorger.
Which one's that?
That's the plus strength.
Okay. Okay, I guess you'd have it. Why don't you roll your miscast? I don't know what's happening, dude.
It's going to be the good one.
26.
Yeah.
So I think it's Small Realm Blast. So with the Small Realm Blast, wait a second, you're 40-20, I'm 45 millimeters from your center. Yeah, he only needs 3, just doing the math correctly. Okay, so you're gonna get 3 of your, you guys.
So we'll do my 3 first.
That's...
It's strength 3,
strength 10.
Strength 10?
It's 3 wounds.
Yeah, that'll do it. So dead. Man.
Your guy takes the strength 10 hit.
He does. He's got a 4 forward, I think, with the Armor of Destiny. Okie dokie.
Okay, he's down 2 wounds. But he healed one from casting the spell, right?
He's got to do the lore attribute after resolving.
So he's down two wounds right now. My two characters are going to lookout serve because they're allowed to. So my BSB, lookout serves, my wizard, lookout serves. So I'm taking three hits, wounding on twos.
Boop.
Two of my guys are going to die.
I lose D6 dice for two. So I got two left. And then lore attribute. Okay, so I heal a wound. So I'm down one wound.
Nice.
Guess we're going to throw two dice at Toothcracker. You stopped it. I don't think you stopped it by that much, technically. But you had multiple dice to throw.
They rolled 5-5, just one, right?
Yeah, you only stopped it by two, technically.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, 5 with a plus 7.
Okay. Let's get over to the fight. Yup.
Want to do this one last? Is there any reason to not do this last?
I don't think so. So, yeah, okay. We'll do the hunter first.
Okay.
Do a fear test.
You cost fear for fear for fear. Leadership going to be, that's a fail, but my BSB. That is also a fail.
Fear me. I'm just one impact attack, strength 5.
That's a wound. Three goes a 5 save. Nope.
I squished the pig. And then I think I got initiative on you, so.
Yeah, for sure.
Let's see what happens. 4 attacks on 3s. Okay, only going to get 2 hits. And then your toughness what?
4, so need 3s.
3s. One more.
5 of a save. Okay. So, if I do nothing to you, I only lose by 1. That's not terrible. So these guys are going to fight. The boars will go first on 5s, and then the spears will go next. 1 hit. Now they're strength 5 because of choppas.
So
strength 4 because of choppas.
Oh, so 5. 5s.
Nothing. All right, so you charged in my flank. But I got a banner, and you... Oh, so you charged flank to the wound. I got a banner. You watch, you won by 2. Because I lost my rank. Yeah, so you won by 2. And that's going to be a fail. We're going to reroll. That's a fail. Dang, okay. You want to chase me down?
Give me a second. Yeah, let's get him.
Okay, I'm going to go... 9.
And I will be going... 4.
Yeah. So they are going to live, and they're going to be... Overboard here. No, overboard here. Yeah. Oh, no, I guess I'm within an inch of them. So I have to go through them, unfortunately. Which is going to do a couple of things. I have to do, oh man, the dangerous train because of the woods. Everybody's fine. But they're going to panic, and they're fine.
Okay. And then Hunter goes forward.
But I'm still technically in the woods.
Yeah.
About an inch away. And then you go forward, you're 3.
All right, let's go over here. You got to roll for the giant at the beginning.
I cause terror!
Okay, so I got to do a fear test for you. I'm not afraid of you.
Now you impact attack first.
Impact attacks. 1, strength 5.
Hey, wounds. I have war paint. No, I take a wound.
Good. I'm glad. All right, so the scrapper goes first. He's weapon skill 2. What do I hit you on, Steve?
5.
It is 5? Would you be
Wait. It can't be 5. It's going to be 4.
Not a 2, though. Yeah. And then what initiative are you?
3. So now I'm going to roll on my chart. The second I find the page for the... There he is. So you're a large thing, right? Okay. I won the combat. Yelling ball. Brawl. Ball. I'm going to double check this. I have nothing in combat by 2, but I don't get the swing. Combat is over. I screamed so loud that everybody just kind of stunned, and I went combat by 2.
Alrighty. Let's see what happens if...
Is that a fail? Your BB?
Yeah, BSB. BSB is close by. I'm leadership 7, by the way.
I guess I'll... Sure. No, I want to charge them.
Jokes on you, they're about to die anyways.
No, I'm not going to chase you, because I got them to deal with.
Okay, so it's still a Swift Stride 3d6.
Yep.
Away for 7. Yeah, second thought, that's still not worth
it.
Let's take it out of here. Well, time for the fun one.
You cause terror by chance.
I don't.
Well, I cause fear because my re-blade. So, no fear tests. I'm initiative 3 or lower.
Initiative 3
or lower? I mean, initiative 2 or lower. No.
Initiative 2 or
lower. He's initiative 3. What weapon is he going to use? He's using a hand weapon, so it'll be initiative 3.
Okay. So that will go at the same time as the breath weapon I'm going to use here.
Okay. Oh, so it makes me always strikes last, but it has the same time? So did you still fight a three or no?
It happens. Basically, I resolve it at initiative three, at his initiative.
Okay, so then I will get to swing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you should still be fine. How many hits am I going to get?
Wait, do you have... Okay, keep that in mind. Do you have impact attacks, actually?
Oh, yeah, I do have impact attacks. I do. I'll do that in a second. So the two hits, these are strength three. So I'm looking for fives. We're rolling ones. Nothing. But at least I got the Obi Strikes last on you. And then, yeah, impact attacks. Five impact attacks at strength five. Rerolling ones. So that should be
four.
Four wounds so far.
These are impact, so they are gonna. I'm not gonna parry that. So
yep.
Four dead.
And then I also get the BSBs.
He's higher strength.
He is higher strength. He's strength six.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Well, my boy here is gonna be hitting your ogres on. I'm assuming threes because you only want to go three, right?
Yes.
I am gonna be strength. Five because of Choppas? So one wound?
One wound, yeah, and it just goes through. Boop. So we're going to remember you caused one wound in this combat so far. Swinging now with all of the hand weapons. Initiative 2 gets to swing before Steve because of the Always Strikes Last. Hitting on fours, rerolling ones.
Ooh.
Okay.
I've never seen you roll so poorly. Well, poorly for you.
It's true.
A lot of threes.
It's true. You know what? If you want to see me roll poorly, go back to the beginning of this bat rep.
That's fair. You only rolled that average-ish.
Now, these are going to wound you on threes rolling ones because of the Bull Gorger. And no ones to reroll.
So your strength five, right? So you ignore my armor, so that's what, three, six, nine?
Nine.
I got a parry. Parry one, so three, six, eight.
And then its initiative always strikes last. Bruiser throwing great weapon attacks. He's got four attacks, hitting on threes. Rerolling ones, but they're all going to hit. And then these are looking for twos. And rerolling ones because the dragon hide. It's still a one, so that's three more wounding hits out of him. And then the Slaughter Master's great weapon, hitting on fours. Rerolling ones. Wounding on twos. Rerolling ones. You owe me another six saves at strength like seven,
yeah,
or something. Yeah,
parry. Three more die, but they get the fight.
Nice.
These two have to fight here, these have to fight here. So we'll do these two into him. Two hits, and I'm strength five right now. So four's the wound?
He's T5 right now.
Oh, five's the wound, so one?
Yep. So it's one wounding hit,
right, minus two.
Heavy armor, so yeah, that just goes through.
Okay. And these two into the wizard. Reroll, here we go. And your toughness?
He's toughness five, I think.
Don't worry about that. And then all of these into the unit.
Okay.
So we're hitting them on threes. Rerolling.
Okay, the reroll didn't help that much.
What are you on threes?
Fours? Or are you strength five?
Five, choppers.
Oh, these are biggins?
Yeah, so three, six, nine, 10, 12, 30, 15, 16, 17 wounds minus two.
That's just the 17 wounds that goes through.
Take out four wounds, because I actually attacked them again.
Oh, okay.
I'll just say those wounds hit as well.
So basically, who dies last out of the command?
Champion.
Champion? So the champion should have... I got to do the stomps as well. So we got a strength six stomp.
Another one?
Yep. And then all of the strength five stomps. These are the strength five stomps. Rerolling ones. Okay, so there's four more there.
After all the combat resolution, Josh still wins by six. But I'm stubborn. I'm good to hold him.
Okay.
I'm going to test a reform. I'm going to pass. I lost by six. So I do not pass. I'm going to reroll that. I can't reform.
Okay, and I got to move my guys. That's what it looks like at the end there.
Okay, not too bad. What on my turn? Well, I guess some animosities. We'll do those boars way over there. That's the wrong die. They're fine. These boys right here are fine. They're doing what to do because they're running and nobody else has to do it. So, charge to declare. Oh no, compulsory first. He's gonna go straight into them.
Yep.
No, he's not.
He's gonna go that direction.
I'm just gonna stop it like that.
Yeah.
That guy over there Oh, he's gonna go that way. And then we're gonna do a lot of things. We're gonna declare these two units charging into them.
Yep.
They're gonna declare a charge into that, so he has to flee.
He does a 3-6. Where am I going?
Wait for me. I think that's gonna be it for my charges.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. So let us do the giant. He rolls a 6. I don't think he was in 12. He's probably gonna fail. Yeah, he fails. But the chariot. Well, I'll almost certainly make it in. Well, I'll measure to make sure.
Yeah,
for sure. He's gonna come up, pivot, and then and the giant's gonna fail forward 6. No, wait, what do you roll again? I forget.
I forget too.
Yeah, he was gonna fail forward that many.
I don't think it's gonna make a huge difference.
It will, it should be over here. And then they're gonna fail their charge, but they're gonna go forward 4. And then we're gonna rally or attempt to. Hey, all right. But,
oh yeah, sorry, these guys.
3 of them are still gonna be in dangerous terrain when they rallied. Actually, yeah, whatever, I'll do it. They're fine. And then this thing here is gonna simply pivot like this, and maybe we'll move like that. Your front's this one?
Yes.
Yeah, we'll do that. That, and then they're gonna march on up. Hey, Winds of Magic. Oh, that's the Tory die again. Okay.
Do I get my channel? No.
All right, first thing I'm gonna try is Gaze of Mork. Casting value 7. I'm gonna get plus 5 to this because I have more things in combat than running.
Gotcha. Now, what does that do?
So I'm gonna roll die 8d6 and a single strength 4 hit. I'm gonna get your him and that if I get them both.
Yeah, you can have it.
Yeah, it's not a lot here. I'm gonna go 10, 26 inches? Yeah, I'll get both.
Yeah, that'll stuff him.
So wounding, what's his toughness?
He's T5.
So I'm on a 5, and the chariot on a 6, I think?
No. Yes.
Oh, 4 dice to hand to Gork. I'm just gonna teleport them. I got it.
I will let you have that, sir.
Okay, so basically I pick a model, I'm gonna take it out of the tray, I'm gonna place him, oh sorry, I forgot to the camera, I went for the big one, the 14 to cast. I go 5d6. Ooh, 10 and 12. So this model's gonna go basically, I don't know, I will say here. And then the rest of the unit piles in around him.
Gotcha.
So they just teleport.
Yeah, you got plenty of space to do that.
And then the last 5 dice for, here we go.
No miscast.
Yeah. Yeah, you got it.
No rerolling. No.
Okay, and back to Dex. Oh, this is interesting.
I think what I'm going to do is call the Death Cheater on him. So this model in base contact with him has to reroll all successful wound rolls against him.
When do you do that?
Combat phase.
Yeah, but when?
Scratch that. You got to hit me first before I can call it.
Wait, so it will probably happen. It'll be D6 plus 1 impact, 2 impact attacks. And then we have to allocate these because this is going to be weird. I forgot who allocates them. You're going to allocate them. So you have to put 1 hit on 2 different models you have to pick.
I'll put 1 on to each character. Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to do the reroll to wound against them?
I'll do the reroll to wound, yeah.
Okay. So, I'm strength
he's
5, T5. You're T5, so 4 to wound, and I got to reroll, right?
Yes, reroll successful.
There's a wound, so no save, right?
No. So he just goes, boop.
And then he's
T5.
So he also takes the 4 wound, so he takes 1.
And he's at a 4 board.
Ooh, nope. We got 2 wounds in. Hmm. 3. Okay, so next is my boars, the initial 3.
Yes.
We're hitting, do I fear you?
Oh.
I don't fear you. Okay. Okay, so my boars are hitting on, I guess we're attacking
now,
that model.
Oh yeah, because you cause fear with the unit.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're attacking that model.
Piece weapon skill.
Little
not really high, right? So 4 for the boars. You know what I forgot to do? Here we go, which I never got, never mind.
Yeah.
And then now initiative 2 for me, so I think you have initiative 3s.
I have 1 initiative 3 in the middle there. He's going to basically be swinging just 5 times. Go, single ogre! 4s! Okay, that's
4 hits. Oh, that was a hit, dude.
No, that was cocked.
All right, sure, but you're holding the camera.
Yeah, I'm the boss, Steve. This is strength 5.
So 3s to wound? Wait, who are you attacking?
This is the him. Unit, yeah.
So that is minus 2 to my save. Why is it strength 5? Oh, because of that.
Yes.
So parry.
Stop! And then I got great weapons and stomps. So I'll let you resolve your stuff first.
So initiative 2 for me then. So 2 spears, hitting him on, I guess, 4s. And I'm strength 5 on the charge because of choppas. That's a wound.
That's a cheater.
That's a wound. No, it's not a wound.
Yeah. Let's get your dice getting thrown. This is always strikes last, though. This is great weapon.
So I'll go with my this guy here, which will use a great weapon, actually. And he'll go after the unit, so I'm going to put the unit down. He's hitting the unit on 3s. And then he's strength 2's the wound. Oh!
I think that still kills him, though.
No, he has 3 wounds tomorrow, don't you?
No. Well, he's down to 1 wound.
Oh!
Yeah. Whew. We're going to pull him out of there. And do the rest of your swings.
Okay. He has to go after him, and these 2 have to go after him. So we'll do him after the wizard. Misses. These 2 after the BSB. 2 hits. And we're only strength 4, so 1 wound.
Okay. Heavy armor?
Yep.
Nope.
Another wound. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. Sorry, everybody. So the rest of attacks I was trying to put at the unit, which are now dead, I had to clear them all at the same time as the great weapon because they're all initiative 1. I wouldn't have declared the unit, but I kind of brain farted. We'll leave it at that. They're not going to hurt
them
anyway.
Are you
sure? Yeah, they're not going to hurt them anyway.
Okay, so great weapon swings off of the big man. Mm-hmm. He should be hitting that unit on 3s and then looking for 2s. So that's 2 wounding hits.
2 dead.
And then the Slaughtermaster, great weapon into the unit. They all hit. They all wound. 3 wound.
3 more.
And then I should have the 3 stomps because it's always strikes last for stomps.
Yep.
Okay. So the 2 that are at strength 5, and then 1 that's at strength 6.
I guess no more. Okay. I actually lost by 1, but I'm stubborn still. We're good.
Okay. Look at you go.
And you got a tight. Actually, he's got T-test too. That's going to be a fail. BSB. He's good.
Okay.
I'll do a quick reform here. I'll re-roll that. And they still can't.
ready. Erk. Because he's gonna move Dan.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the right way to do this. He has 3 left. All right then. Yeah. Let's get ready for Ogre's turn 3. I got 4 models left.
Hey everybody. He's in the swamp. He passed initiative. He's good.
How do you do that? what witchcraft is this? Okay, so start of my turn, charge to declare. You know what? The hunter, go get that unit of orcs. We're going to kill them eventually.
You're automatically in.
I still got to roll the ogre charge, see if he gets extra.
Oh, okay, sure.
Always roll the ogre charge.
How much you need?
I don't get it. It's going to be 10.
I'm going to roll that cannon.
Yep. Cannon. Yeah, he's cool. This is cool.
Where's he going to aim?
Yeah.
Is that your moonfish?
That, yeah. I only had 2 models I was allowed to move.
You're in the swamp.
Yeah, I know I am. Thank you, Steve.
What'd you roll?
4.
What's your highest initiative?
3.
You're losing 2 6 models.
All right, cool.
You want to call it?
Yeah, good game, sir.
Vault members, go ahead and check out the link below to see the next game. We're going to re-rack. My ogres are once again going to do battle against Steve and his orcs and goblins. If you're not a vault member, you can check out the link below. Anyways, takes you to a 7-day free trial where you get to check out this game, as well as everything else we have in the vault. Everything we do in pairs. It's twice as much content, tons of fun stuff. Thanks for tuning in, and see you there.
Okay, this was hilarious, because I had a conversation with a couple boys last night. And
okay, who did you actually have the conversation with?
I did not.
You can't give away your sources. Okay, yes.
Okay, so ogres are kind of like up here, first or second best army in fantasy. I think dark elves are worse, but like, it's arguable. Orcs are like at the bottom, arguably the third worst. And I'm trying to figure out how to play against ogres today. Now I know Josh isn't going to bring a super top tier list because he's always playing against orcs and goblins. But I didn't know what to do. So talking to some buddies, and we're like going through my models, and like there's nothing I could, like there's a couple of lists that I could make that could fight ogres quite well if you tailor against them, but I don't have the models for it. So like, okay, you know what? Just forget all the shenanigans. Just put your boys at the table, run forward, and let the dice win the game for you. And boy, howdy, did that work. This should not have worked at all. Josh lost his lead belchers right away on a failed animosity test, which was dumb.
Yep.
And then everything just perfectly went my way.
You failed your test, too. Like, I think I still should have won that combat, but I don't know the math on it 100%. But still, I feel like I should have won that combat.
I don't know, man. I don't feel like this was, again, one of the weirdest. Like, this shouldn't have went my way.
Yeah, and I lost. I think the thing that killed the most is probably the Famir.
Yeah, the swamp swallowed up at least six of your models.
Well, because it got four ogres, but then it also got the like four regular ogres, which kind of sense.
So
then that's like a 400-point character or something like that, and a, I don't know, like a 200 something.
But not my guys. My guys are too faster than Famir. Totally earned victory. Totally earned.
Yep. Yep. Maybe I should have picked the one with regen. I mean, granted, we picked random name, whatever sounded cool. I just wanted to pick one that I could yell, get out of my swamp.
Why? But, when you go at the table, why'd you put a swamp right dead center?
I didn't know what swamps did.
That's fair to die.
Yeah. See? That's why!
One, because of terrain and amazing dice. The orc gods are always in my favor. I had nothing else to say. Like, I brought a giant. They're terrible. Boar boys, there aren't biggins, no character support in them. I brought a bunch of clan boys and a horde of biggins. Like, it shouldn't have worked.
Happy wargaming. Yeah, no, I don't know.
I know, I'm with you. What do you
think? This is one of the first times I've ever played orcs. I think I played against Matthew with 1T, but if memory serves correct, I don't think that was a happy day for him, so I didn't actually know what they did. They seemed kind of cool. They kind
of... I just want to buy... There's a bunch of orcs I now want to buy and paint up to fight the ogres. I need black orcs. It's not our things, but yeah.
Yeah.
What a game. Happy wargaming.